Hi, my name's Jan. I'm a scientist at the Crick Institute, and I thought a good way to show you the structure of a cell is to make it on a cupcake with some sweeties. You don't have to make this cupcake yourself, you can buy them from the shops. Just make sure there's a little bit of buttercream on top to stick the sweets on. So let's go over to the counter and I'll show you how. So first of all, what are cells? So our bodies are made up of trillions of building blocks called cells, which work together to keep your body running. Your body is made up of a lot of different types of cells with different functions. So you'll probably recognise the cells that I'm going to describe. So like you've got different cells like brain cells, lung cells, liver cells, and even skin cells. Now, the Francis Crick Institute studies all types of cells, understanding about how the human body works, both when healthy and, more importantly, during disease. So here's a cupcake I made earlier. You don't have to make your own. You can buy them, but just make sure that you have a little bit of buttercream on top so you can stick your sweeties on. So the cells in real life are filled with different organelles that do different jobs within the cell. And so here we are, we're using a cupcake for the main body part of the cell, and the sweets represent the organelles. So let's go. So first of all, I'm going to get a strawberry lace, and this represents the cell membrane, or the plasma membrane if you want to use a fancier name for it. But cell membrane, basically it's exactly how it describes. It's a membrane surrounding the cell, and the function of it, this surrounds the cell and keeps content separate from its surroundings, because without it, it would just plop out all over the place. And then it also controls what moves in and out of the cell. So basically it's like a guard. And then next thing is a fried egg. So love these. So the fried egg will represent nucleus. And this contains, it's like the brain, it contains the cell's instructions in the form of DNA. So there's DNA in the center. And that controls what the cell does. Remember I said that different cells have different functions? So this will tell it what it should be doing, its job. Okay, so next up is the mitochondria. So I'm going to choose a nice purple one. Put that on there. So the mitochondria is quite clever. It's the powerhouse of the cell. It's able to take oxygen and sugar and then convert it into energy for the cell to use. So next up is the smarty. I'm going to use a green one, make it more colourful. And the smarty represents a lysosome. So lysosome, if you know a little bit of Latin, lysis means to break up. Lysosome, these are like the recycling centres of the cell, and they take unwanted material and break them down to individual components that can be reused again. So it's very clever. It's a bit like recycling center you take your plastics and paper to. So that's a lysosome. Let's put that right there. Next up, oh, jelly rings. Love jelly rings as well. Okay, so these ones, jelly rings, will represent the vesicles. Now the vesicles are fluid filled sacs, so in real life they'll be like fluid filled, and these transport things between different parts of the cell and the cell membrane. So it's like a transport system. It's like a whole world in the cell there. And then finally, I've got cut up rainbow wands. So just snip them with rainbow wands, just snip them with some scissors. And these represent, now this is a really strange name, the Golgi apparatus, also known as the Golgi body. And these produce the vesicles and the lysosomes. So all you need to know is the Golgi apparatus makes these two. And I'm gonna just put that right there. So give it a lot of space in between. And there you have it. A nice cell cupcake that you can have with a nice cold glass of milk. Thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna go and have this with a cup of tea. But in the meantime, once you've decorated your cupcakes, take a picture and put it on Instagram with the hashtag Discovery Week and the hashtag Everyone's a Scientist, and also tag at Francis Crick Institute. You've got a chance of winning a little prize for the best one, and I wish you all good luck. Bye.